Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Pink Panther in Hokus Pokus Pink. We are continuing with our adventures to, well, essentially bring the little girl back to full health. We cured her ninja mermaid princess stage, but that in turn turned her into a zombie. And I'm guessing something about the fact that we used his mom's veggies, cooked veggies in there, had something to do with it. So let's try following her and see where she went. Down there, I suppose. In here, as far as I remember.
I can explain everything!
Explain what, dear heart?
Didn't she, don't you what,
kitten?
Never mind. As you were.
And now, the moment you have all been waiting for. Without any further ado, may I present...
The Star's Bite Collection.
Ah!
Eat on jewelry, huh?
I want to buy the whole thing. How much?
That's not fair. He can't buy the whole thing. Some of us want to purchase individual teeth.
Too bad. I have a lot of money, and I want them all.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's keep our wits about us. I'm certain we can reach an arrangement that benefits me exclusively.
And this is zombie dude.
Oh my, she's ruined the ambiance.
Violet, is that you?
That must mean a yes.
We don't usually allow her to belch, or levitate above the room, or get possessed as she seems to be.
What in the world is that thing? And how much do you want for it?
I don't think it's for sale, is it, darling?
Sure it is, Muffin. Sure it is.
That thing is your daughter, Mr. Izumi.
Is she having
this guy's
an
shocked
asthma
beyond
attack?
Comprehension.
This is the strangest party I have ever been to.
Word to your mother.
Can I have your attention, please?
Very dramatic.
I am the evil spirit of Echidna. I now possess Violet.
Hi, Echidna.
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 Hi. Now, I don't want to be here any more than you want me to be here. Apparently, someone was tampering with the mysterious forces of the unknown, and the next thing I know, I'm trapped in the body of an overweight toddler.
Not overweight. Just big bone.
Whatever. Now, in order to exorcise my spirit, you'll need to contact the most powerful man in the universe.
But how are we going to get Steven Spielberger on such short notice?
Who says it's Spielberger? I think it's Pat Swoon. That man is unstoppable.
I think she means Zeus.
Zeus?
Echidna was a dreaded monster from Greek mythology, with the upper body of a woman and lower body of a gruesome serpent. Since, as you just proved, power is subjective and our subject to the spirit of a mythical creature from fabled Greece, it stands to reason that from Echidna's point of view, Zeus is the most powerful man in the universe, Zeus being the king of all gods. But I could be wrong.
Then I have to go back to that fabled time of Mount Olympus, when Greek gods did max and relax on the highest mountain in Greece.
Alright then. We'll get there soon. First, I want to check what's in your purse.
I suppose I'll be needing this!
We're either Aphrodite or Persephone, if I recall correctly. And then we will also be requiring this camera, if I recall correctly.
Never can tell when you'll need to say cheese.
True.
him.
Ahem.
Can anybody do anything apart from cough?
Ahem.
Apparently not. And she's busy going full exorcist mode, so I guess we just head over into Ancient Greece now. Only a very limited number of places we can go at this point. But yeah, this game is not educational, it's just... I mean, it is educational, you're just learning about the traditional beliefs of places rather than the modern-day status. At any rate. Oh, there's a page!
Hey, the last missing page!
So, he pulls his chariot right out, without looking, and he cuts me off in the middle of traffic. I'm the god of wine in altered states, and I'm telling you, if he wasn't... Sorry, Zeus, but I speak the truth.
Right, so I was about to say that's probably Dionysus, but he's drunk. Problem with Dionysus is, as soon as wine touches his lips, it turns into water. He was cursed by Zeus, and he can't get drunk, even though he's the god of wine.
Hi, I'm Aphrodite, goddess of love.
Thought as much. We probably give you the perfume, though.
Hi, I'm Aphrodite.
I'd like to have a word with Zeus. How do I reach him?
You don't reach him, he reaches you. That's the way it goes when you're the king of the gods.
Well, that's true. Pegasus.
That's Pegasus, the winged horse.
The musical.
My mother left as I arrived. She would only be missed by me. With a pair of snakes and a stony gaze, Medusa, you're finally free. My father blessed with sons and daughters, and of course, stormy sea. And it took me years to understand there were never any others like me. When horses fly, when dreamers sigh, when wells run dry, I can't help try. Poseidon wonders why Medusa says goodbye. Who wants to have a try and ride a horse that flies? Athena captured Pegasus. Oh, it's the one and only horse with wings. Men or would-be heroes would use me to accomplish great things. And be careful. Somehow still I fly. from the mark sprung a great spring. But this water is real, but am I not? I guess myths were always entertaining. I would trade my wings, I'd fly to know that I'm really real. You can keep me alive in your storybooks by imagining how odd it feels to when horses fly, when dreamers sigh, when whales run dry. I can't help trying. Poseidon wonders why Medusa said goodbye. I've had my mother die, yet somehow still I fly. When dreamers sigh, when horses.
I like the art and the musical videos in this game quite a lot, but not the music itself. I never really did like musicals either. And I'm guessing this guy's Ares.
Hey man, I'm Ares, God of War. And let me tell you, the Family Feud is just getting started. Between my temperamental dad Zeus and my vengeful uncle Poseidon and my stubborn half-sister Athena, by the time this family spat is worked out, there will be nothing left of Mount Olympus!
Well, look who washed up. How's it going, Poseidon?
Is there any news on Echidna?
Not since Zeus swallowed Athena again!
It is for the really? Best. That ornery woman will bring trouble to all.
Maybe I'm just being dense, but if Athena is responsible for Echidna's disappearance, how is she going to be able to help you from the pit of Zeus's stomach?
Silence!
Did you say Echidna?
Yes. Echidna is my granddaughter. She has the head of a beautiful nymph, but the body of a serpent. Zeus spared her and her children's lives as challenges to future heroes. She is missing. Do you have any information on her?
Let's suppose that someone accidentally cast a spell that made her disappear.
It would be just like Athena to do something like that.
How could we reverse it?
I suppose only Athena herself would know the answer.
Okay. So, if I ask her nicely?
Silence!
God Poseidon, he's always storming off.
He and Athena have been quarreling for years. He's too stubborn to ask her nicely for help.
Well, I'm not. If I could just speak to Athena, I'm sure I could convince her.
Good luck. As you heard before, Zeus swallowed her whole. Now she's stuck in his head.
There must be some way I can attract Zeus's attention.
It's like, so Athena was basically born from Zeus's temple or head, and she's hence the goddess of wit. So I suppose it the logic follows that, well, she's now stuck in her head, stuck in Zeus's head. The trident.
I may be in hot water with Poseidon. This trident could come in handy.
Let's see where it takes us. The trident, I mean. The perfume, though, I'm pretty sure we have to give it to Aphrodite.
That smells divine. Do you have any idea how much easier that wonderful fragrance would make my job? Spray it on me, please.
I'll let you have the whole bottle if you help me attract Zeus.
You spray that on me, and Zeus will be here before you can say...
Divinity?
Whatever. Oh, Zeus.
Silence.
Something smells divine. The purest fume I ever did with.
That's funny. For as good as it smells, the bottle said it's just water that came from a toilet.
I don't have time for your games, Aphrodite. I've got a splitting headache over here.
Maybe you ate something that didn't agree with you.
Enough of the funny business, Dionysus. You're on my last nerve over here.
Zeus, the ever-horny bastard, huh? Won't even spare his daughter. Anywho, I'm guessing this is where we use the trident. And, yeah. Or the toilet that I can't exactly pronounce that word. It's French for, well, water from the toilet, but it's used to refer to perfumes of a lesser concentration as compared to eau de parfum, which is pretty much perfumes of higher concentration. And then there's cologne, which is at the very bottom, which is supposed to be primarily water with some aromatic elements or hints to it. So, yeah. Whoops. Let us go ahead and use this trident on Zeus's head.
I would have thought you'd learned your lesson, Daddy. Thank you, pink god of headaches.
Not a problem.
Wrong. She is a problem. She has done some sort of trickery with her cousin Echidna.
I told you, I didn't do anything with that half-woman, half-serpent beast.
Then who is responsible for the disappearance? Which of you dare dabble in the field of fire and found yourself burned a fiery shade of pink? Was it you, god of headaches?
It was all a terrible mishap. You see, there was this cauldron and a little boy in trouble, and a big hairy girl and some leftover Greek salad. And the next thing I knew, Echidna was stuck in Violet, and Violet is who knows where.
You are responsible for the disappearance of Echidna? You, god of headaches? This is not good. Your fate will be decided by the completion of two really difficult, nearly impossible tasks. You must succeed in both to win your life.
Mm-hmm. But...
There are no buts on Mount Olympus.
Doesn't that make sitting uncomfortable?
Let the challenge begin.
Hold on. Don't I get someone to help me train for this event?
I suppose.
Who is this?
Apollo.
Apollo Creed.
How you doing?
Been better.
We gotta get you into shape.
I like the fact that they actually make the Greek gods darker in shade, because, I mean, that's pretty much how Greeks, I believe, are. They're tanned for the most part.
Brownish in color. Let us begin. The first task will be similar to a task my son Perseus was victorious in. Mm-hmm. You must slay the two remaining Gorgons. Perseus beheaded Medusa with the aid of Athena and Hermes. Now you must put the remaining two Gorgons out of commission, yet spill no blood. Capiche? But beware,
comprende.
For their gaze alone can turn you to stone. Bring proof of your victory, but do not slay them.
How do I get there?
Why don't you take Pegasus, the winged horse? It sprang forth from Medusa when her head was cut off by Perseus. I'm sure he remembers the way to the Gorgons.
No sweat, I'll be back in a flash. Meanwhile, don't get your sheets in a bunch.
I really like the warship tattoo on Poseidon's chest here. Anyhow, I suppose that's why we still have this, the reflective surface on the inside of this, well, dish cover, I suppose. And off we go to meet the Gorgons. Averting his eyes, as his wife.
Thanks for the ride, Pegasus!
Alright, anything here? Nothing much, I suppose.
I am Euryale.
I am Steno.
We are the remaining Gorgons.
Turn around so we can see ya.
Must not look at snakeheads.
Alright, so I guess we turn them into stone and then click a picture of them using our camera.
Who ordered the Greek salad?
Food, glorious food. Do you know what it's like living in this swamp? We can't even get a pizza delivered. Oh, I'm turning to stone.
That's what you get for being greedy. Let that be a lesson to all you kids out there.
What now? The camera? I'm missing something here. I do believe I'm missing something here. Let's check in Greece once, on Mount Olympus, and then we can probably check elsewhere. Back at the mansion, I mean.
Whatever!
Return so soon? Did you defeat the Gorgons?
I'm working on it.
Hi, I'm Aphrodite, goddess of love.
How you doing?
Apollo Creed. Nice twist there. So Apollo is basically supposed to be the messenger god of the Greek pantheon, and he's primarily supposed to take care of the medical aspect as well. He's supposed to be the god of medicine as well, and lawyers too. And Hermes is supposed to be the messenger. I'm sorry, Apollo is supposed to be the god of medicine and law.
Thanks for the ride, Pegasus.
Alright, now we head back to... well, the mansion, and see what we're missing. Because we definitely need something right now. We're sort of missing an ingredient here. Nothing from the tooth collection, I suppose.
Him.
That guy can't cough for whatever reason.
Him.
The drinks won't help us any.
Ah. I suppose I'll be needing this too.
Of course, we just had to click on it again. Any reflective surface works apparently. Alright, now to present the mirror to this woman here. This here Gorgon. Now, the thing is, Medusa was supposed to be very, very beautiful, and these women are, well, they could not be far from could not be any farther from beautiful, to be honest.
Ahem, excuse me, miss, I believe you have a little something stuck in your teeth. You might want to,
Why don't you take a picture and last longer? You guys will be standing here for eternity.
Say, headache!
Headache!
I guess we have no need for any of this. Pretty sure the patrons at the house will be missing all of this. The guests at the house, I mean. Patrons are supposed to be paying guests. Alright, then. Picture of these three folks for Zeus.
Now this is called a photograph. Say it with me. photograph. It captures the image of...
Let me see that thing. I can't believe it. I can't believe it.
It's amazing, isn't it? So lifelike and...
Well, let's see how you fare in the brains competition. I hope you've been brushing up on your Greek mythology.
In this corner, weighing in at approximately 343 pounds, about half of which is water retention, is the mighty and vengeful Poseidon, god of the sea!
Water retention because he's the god of the sea.
In this corner, weighing in at...
About 98 pounds.
About 98 pounds is the pink, swim or sink, god of headaches!
Yay, Pink Panther,
thanks for your support.
Answer the questions posed or die.
Thanks, D. I'll take answer the question posed for 100.
When Athena got word that Medusa I kissed in a temple dedicated to she turned Medusa's hair into a frightful wicked scare by transforming her locks into these.
Snakes. So, as far as Gorgons go, it's not their eyesight that is dangerous, it's looking at the snakes that is the more dangerous part. The snake's eyesight is what turns you into stone, and not the Gorgon's eyes themselves.
So you're lucky this time, but I'll quickly remind. Answer 4 out of 5, or you won't get out alive.
Bring it on!
It's you, baby! It's all you!
When Athens was looking to choose its patron, the choice was Poseidon or me. So, gifts we did make, and the tie would soon break. Which gift was it that came from me?
Interesting.
That one's not a match. If the next one you scratch, the battle is over. For here is the catch. Answer 4 out of 5 or you won't get out alive.
Right. Now which gift was it that came from he?
Though your answer was good, you're not yet out these woods. Mm-hmm. You must answer 2 more to walk free out that door.
I see.
As you may have well noted, many gods here have doted. And if wed still consorts were present, who fathered all these? The answer's a breeze. This son of Kronos fought in with a vengeance. Who fathered Hermes, Ares, Apollo, and me? Perseus, Dionysus, and the great Heracles.
This guy here. Zeus.
Right, as you said, Zeus did plan ahead when seeking to woo a new woman. He disguised himself well for such deeds. Which form did this sly fox not call in?
A goose.
No, silly. A sandwich. He never called on a woman disguised as a sandwich. Come on.
Oh, that's true.
Poseidon, your victim.
Wait, if you kill me, you'll never find Echidna. Let me take you to where she is. Then you'll see this is all a big misunderstanding. After all, I did complete that thingy with the Gorgons.
The god of headaches is right. He
the
did
last
complete
one was a
the Gorgon task.
Trick question.
I will go with him to find Echidna. And if it was an honest mistake as you profess, you will live.
So yeah, it was... The last thing was a trick question, to be honest. He took the form of goose to seduce a woman and apparently bull as well. But as it turns out, they were asking what form he did not take, which is the part where I was not paying attention. And yeah, he did not take the part of a ham sandwich.
We're not walking, are we?
Alright then.
We'll take my chariot.
He pulled Poseidon into it. It's Poseidon, though. Only one place left to go. And here we go, down the rabbit hole. The wormhole, rather.
Chillo, everyone, this is Poseidon. Poseidon, this is everyone.
What happened to Zeus?
Well, Poseidon is Echidna's grandfather and...
Echidna, get down here now!
We don't usually allow her to belch, or levitate above the room, or get possessed as she seems to be.
I won't tolerate another moment of this nonsense. Echidna, it's time to go home!
Well, what are you going to do?
What can I do? She won't listen!
Bibi Fi, Feely Gook, Gleepy Glaucoma, Violet be backy now, Nightmare be over!
Then boom.
Duck! She's gonna blow!
Zeus is here.
Zeus? Is that you?
No!
I know it's not Carl Swethers.
No, but good guess.
Ah! Why are we screaming?
Because he's scary. He's really scary.
Enough!
Let's go home. I have a headache.
Why don't you take 2 aspirin and call me in the morning?
Sure thing.
Oh, terrible dream. Violet, let's go home now.
Can we keep him?
How much?
It's on the house.
Really?
You're nothing without celebrity teeth. Do you hear me? Nothing.
I thought if I had fancy teeth, people would want to hear me sing. But after all this craziness, I wouldn't touch those things.
I think you have a splendid voice, Shaky.
That means the world to me coming from you, Saltina. May I escort you home?
Why, thank you. I would like that very much.
Wait, what about the teeth?
Well, everybody's being disinterested in...
You're nothing without celebrity teeth. Do you hear me? Nothing!
High society antics now.
I was never here for the teeth. I was here for the free food. Cheers!
And I think I've learned something tonight. If none of these important rich people need these teeth to make them feel rich and important, then by golly, neither do I!
Good job. Good job.
Wait, what about the teeth?
You're nothing without celebrity teeth. Do you hear me? Nothing!
Ah, Himeki! I couldn't have hoped for a better ending. Now you will finally be complete.
What are you going to do now, Himeki?
I'm gonna run for mayor!
Nathan Jr., you have done it this time. Do you hear me? You have done it.
This is it for you, buddy. The last straw.
This time, you're definitely going away to the Young Gums Academy. Do you hear me? I should have sent you years ago.
All I ever wanted to do was be a magician. Now I failed at that, too.
Now, Nathan, it's partially my fault. You see, I saw promise in you, and I wanted to challenge your skills. So I intervened a bit here and there, stuck my nose where it didn't belong. You did the best
that
you
is a
could
long moves.
Under the circumstances.
Even with your help, I couldn't fix anything. I'm a failure.
I know of one thing you did all by yourself that was a complete and total success. A real testimony to your skill as a sorcerer.
What?
The poison apple. It worked just like you wanted it to, and Strange Blood didn't help you with it at all.
Hey, that's true!
Nathan, how would you like to study with me? You could be my apprentice. I'll teach you everything I know about magic.
What about my parents?
I have a feeling they will agree.
I guess the teeth grew back.
Bye, Nathan. Good luck with the magic. Goodbye, Strange Blood. You're neither strange nor blood. Discuss amongst yourselves. It's all back in place. You know, when I took that job as a traveling salesman, I had no idea just how far I'd be traveling. I guess it doesn't matter much where I go. There's always going to be a fantastic adventure.
And I suppose...
So, let me ask you something. How did you make that poison apple?
In due time, Strange Blood. In due time.
So I suppose that's the end of Pink Panther and Hokus Pokus Pink for you guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end of not only this video, but throughout the entire playthrough. Now, this game, it seemed, was the puzzle seemed easier for one. Maybe it's because I have played the hell out of it as a child, but it seems more puzzle-oriented than education-oriented. And at the same time, they didn't really, you know, go overboard with the back-and-forth aspect as well. Even though, I mean, this level design was quite emergent. You had to travel to different levels, and it wasn't exactly linear that you solve this portion first, and then you get to go to the other portion. It was more or less like you essentially collect helpful stuff from around all the places that you can visit, and you use it for your own benefit. So, yeah, that was that for Pink Panther and Hocus Pocus Pink. I actually really liked this game. Really like this game. I didn't find myself getting bored, unlike with Pink Panther in Pink Panther's Passport to Peril. So, yeah, this was an entertaining game. And that brings us to the end of the Pink Panther series. There are more Pink Panther games, but they're mostly platformers, and I honestly dislike platformers. So, yeah, I do plan on covering more point-and-click adventures, including Siberia and other ones. However, as far as the recent future goes, or the foreseeable future goes, I don't see myself playing any other, how do I put this, point-and-click adventure. So, yeah, we'll get back with something in this genre, I mean. We'll get back with more point-and-click adventures. Until then, I will be continuing on with my playthrough of Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. And as far as other games are concerned, we will be covering something else alongside that as well. So, yeah. Until next time, in whatever video it is that we meet, take care. Fare thee well, fellow earthlings.